Gordon was resting in a siding when Henry came by and said,
"Hello, fat face! Hello, fat face!"
Gordon was furious.
"What cheek! What cheek! That Henry is too big for his wheels. Fancy speaking to me like that. To me. To me, who has never had an accident. Never, ever had an accident."
Percy was a bit puzzled. "Oh, but Gordon, aren't jammed whistles and burnt safety valves accidents?"
"No, indeed, they are not accidents. Not accidents. They're, well, they're just high spirits. I mean, it might happen to any engine, but to come off the rails, well, I ask you, is it right? Is it decent,
A few days later, it was Henry's turn to take the express. Gordon watched him getting ready.
"Better be careful, Henry. You're not pulling the flying kipper now, you know. Mind you keep to the rails today, won't you,
Fat face, shh, fat face, shh, fat face, shh, fat face, shh, shh."
And Henry went on his way. But Gordon didn't care. He yawned and went off to sleep. But he didn't sleep long, because his driver came along and said,
"Come on, wake up, Gordon. A special train's coming and we're to pull it."
Special train? Is it coaches or trucks?"
"It's trucks."
"Oh, trucks. I don't like trucks."
They lit Gordon's fire and oiled him ready for the run. The fire was sulky and wouldn't burn, but they couldn't wait, so Edward pushed him onto the turntable to get him facing the right way. Gordon grumbled like anything.
"I won't go, I won't go, I won't go."
Edward said,
"Don't be silly, don't be silly, don't be silly."
Gordon tried hard, but he couldn't stop himself being moved. At last, he was on the turntable. Edward was uncoupled and backed away, and Gordon's driver and fireman jumped down to turn him round. The movement had shaken Gordon's fire. It was now burning nicely and making steam. But Gordon was cross and didn't care what he did. He waited till the table was halfway round and he said,
"I'll show 'em. I'll show 'em."
And he moved slowly forward. He only meant to go a little way, just far enough to jam the table and stop it turning as he'd done once before. But he couldn't stop himself, and he crashed through the side of the turntable and then through some wooden railings, and he slipped and slithered down a bank into a ditch. His wheels churned around in the mud.
"Oh, hey, my wheels are spinning. I can't get out. I can't get out. Please get me out. Please get me out."
But his driver and fireman said, "No. Not a hope, not a hope. You're stuck, you silly great engine, you silly great engine. Don't you understand that? Don't you understand that, They telephoned the fat controller, who said,
"Yes, yes, yes. Oh, so Gordon didn't want to take the special and ran into a ditch, Oh, yes. What's that you say? The special's waiting? Well, tell Edward to take it, please. Yes. Gordon? Oh, leave him where he is. We haven't got time to bother about him now."
A family of frogs croaked at Gordon as he lay in the mud.
"Gordon, Gordon, 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 Gordon."
On the other side of the ditch, some little boys shouted out,
"Cool, doesn't he look silly? They'll never get him out."
And they began to sing,
Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch. Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch all on a Monday morning.
Then the school bell rang and they chased off down the road. Gordon was in a mess and he said, and he blew away three tadpoles and an inquisitive newt. And Gordon lay in the ditch all day long. And he was very, very unhappy.
Oh, dear. I shall never get out. I shall never get out.
But that evening, they brought floodlights. Then, with powerful jacks, they lifted Gordon and made a road of sleepers under his wheels to keep him from the mud. Strong wire ropes were fastened to his back, and James and Henry, pulling hard, at last managed to bring him to the rails. Late that night, Gordon crawled home, a sadder and a wiser engine.